80s pop star Taylor Dayne sharing her health battle with colon cancer.
Who can forget her voice, right? For years, Taylor Dayne was riding high, an unstoppable force. Her performance schedule still jammed until this past summer when she hit a roadblock with this frightening health scare.
So tell me, what have you been suffering from?
It was a really sudden experience. I went in for a routine colonoscopy. He said, I cut a very aggressive polyp. We're we're going to do a biopsy on it. And he said it was really large. And he came back and he goes, yeah, it's very cancerous and it's a very aggressive form. And you need surgery. I'm sitting there with stage one, stage something cancer. Yeah. That's really what happened as of July. So that's not even 6 months ago. I made a decision that I was going to do a limited cut. And then I had massive complications during surgery.
You got an infection?
I think we nicked a blood vessel and the bleeding out. I created a hematoma around my spleen. Your spleen and your lungs and your pancreas, everything is just so close. They couldn't get in there and drain it. I got an abscess and a nice big old infection.
So you've obviously in recovery.
I am. This turned into a big traumatic time for me because the pain was excruciating.
The body's response is always pain to show us something's going on.
Yeah.
And one of the things I was thinking about you when you told me you had this was, Ayurveda says, what was going on before? What was going on a year ago, 2 years ago, 5 years ago, 10 years ago? Because the root cause is in the past.
Yeah.
So we consider a headache started and it can turn into cancer. We don't think that way. So the body will develop a growth when it can't get rid of something from the body naturally.
Interesting.
So when it can't sweat it out, when it can't pee it out, and when it can't come out in feces, the three main ways we get rid of waste, it starts to grow. So tumor is just basically something that grows out of energy and as rubbing. So if I rub my hands continuously like that, I'll get a callus.
Yes.
Then if I keep rubbing that callus, I'll get a hard piece that keeps growing and growing. And I'm manifesting that growth by just rubbing my hands together, right? And then eventually the body goes into protective mode of something is attacking me.
Interesting.
So the body has such intelligence, but most of the time our mind is getting us into the trouble. Because the mind says, we can go further. I can push a little bit more. So you're a performer, you've been on the road lots of years. And one of the things I was thinking about was you've been pushing and pushing and pushing and you keep a really rigorous performance. You know, you're out there, right? That takes so much energy that energy is our healing mechanism, right? Yeah. You're giving it to thousands of people, but then you haven't kept a lot of it for yourself. When we're at our lowest point of energy, the things that were manifesting or we had under control, we were managing, start to pop up. So your routine has a lot to do with what's going on, right? So let's get into that. Like, what time do you get up in the morning?
Average 10 o'clock.
10 o'clock, okay.
I mean, it changes because I travel all the time and I'll go like 5 days of just like 5 a.m., 5 a.m., 5 a.m., planes, trains, and automobiles.
What time do you go to bed?
One.
Straight away, one thing, the colon, when it's disturbed, we call it the disturbance of air element, vata energy.
Okay.
So there's five elements in the world. Ether, space, air, which makes everything move, fire, water, and earth. So you have less earthiness. Earthiness is about grounding. It's how we keep our immune system and our nervous system grounded.
Yeah.
You have a lot of fire and air. Fire and air are beautiful, wonderful for passion, but they're the worst things for recovery. That's the earth element. So, and colon is all about air. When that's disturbed, like it is in you, because you had a piece of your colon taken out, your colon isn't now in trauma. So it's going to give you all kind of different issues like constipation and, you know, things like that. You won't be able to digest food as properly. And then, like you said, not always hungry, you know. So what you eat is going to be really imperative because it needs to be nutritious.
Yeah.
And it needs to be earthy. So if you eat a salad, for example, it's going to be the worst thing because it's full of air. But if you eat rice with a little ghee, it's heavier and things need to be a little heavier.
Hmm.
Right? So you're making it grounded. So when you eat, you feel a little bit heaviness, not a lot, but you feel like, okay, I feel good.
Yeah.
This is grounding me.
Sure.
So I'm talking about your routine. Let's start with diet first. So let's move to the kitchen and we'll continue that.
Well, firstly,
okay, all right,
there's a lot of things.
Ghee. So ghee is perfect because it's grounding and it's oily. Oil is great for balance and earthiness. So great. So what's the first thing you put into your body in the morning?
Generally warm, lemon mixed with the vital proteins, you see the peptides. I will mix something like that in it today.
So what I suggest is you only do hot water when you first start the day. Drinking hot water allows everything to settle.
Okay.
And then what will happen is 15 minutes later, you have to read, what is my body telling me? What does it want next? It may not want this because this is also takes up digestive power.
Yeah.
In that moment, it might say, give me some more hot water. Give me hot water with lemon. Give me a tea of ginger. Or whatever, right?
Okay.
So we want to get into understanding what this system wants. So we're not just living by, okay, I just got to get this out of the way. Then I got to do that. Then I got to get my
I know, but that's like literally I give myself my half hour to do what I got to do and then I'm out the door.
Exactly. But because you're in recovery and you've been through so much trauma, you're going to have to spend a little more time with it.
Okay.
Doesn't mean you need more time than half an hour. It just means you got to give yourself a moment to read the body. So Ayurvedic medicine is about self-awareness. What's happening here?
I thought dinner's at six. Like,
no, it's
funny.
Everything in every moment is different. If I'm more emotional and I was talking to my mom and this happened, that happened. So now what you ate yesterday is not going to go down well today if you were super chilled out yesterday. It's just being more aware. Because here, all of this is great, but it's too much.
Yeah.
Or your system doesn't need all of this stuff.
Yeah.
More is not better, definitely. Especially when we're taking supplements, herbal medicines.
Yeah.
Because if you take even herbal medicines in too much of a dosage, the body has to get rid of the excess.
Yeah.
So that's energy. Let's have a look at your fridge. What's going on in there?
Good luck.
This is great.
Is it?
This is like one of the cleanest and emptiest fridges I've seen. So one of the things I would say is when you eat, always see how you feel here in the gut, not in the mind.
Yeah.
Because the mind is the thing that wants the satiation, the experience, the taste, right?
Okay. Yeah.
We want to take everything from here and we want to feel it here. So when you're eating your eggs, instead of, oh, this is great, it's more about how does it making me feel here?
Okay. I think you're right. My lifestyle is just very action-packed.
Think about it that way. You need buffers to buffer that heat that you put out. When you're moving a lot, don't drink coffee, for example, because it just makes the movement worse because it gives you, right? Go to something like a chamomile tea. Go to something like a piece of bread or something that is heavier. Suddenly it will buffer all that movement because it will bring, you know, the earthiness in. So more about your routine. What do you do? So you get up and then what do you do most days?
I'll do a workout of some nature.
Again, you're going to have to, even when you work out, you're going to have to keep a balance of earthiness. When you move very slowly, things are more earthy.
Yeah.
When you move quicker, they're more airy and fiery. So tell me about sleep. How's your sleep?
I definitely need help.
Okay.
And that's just more of something that I've been challenged with for the last many, many years.
Each part of the day has an element to it. And nighttime is really to do with fire and air. But before 10, earthiness is there. That's why you start to feel tired. You start to yawn, right? That's the body saying, I want to get into an earthy mode because I naturally know that mode makes me sleep. The fire and the air mode make me wake up and make me excited, make me want to move. After 10 at night, generally is a creative time for people, especially artists, because air and fire take over.
Yeah.
And that's why all that thing starts to happen, but it's the worst thing for sleep. That makes your condition worse because you're feeding the fire and the air again, right? It makes the body drier. It makes the digestion off.
A lot of my creative thinking happens at that time.
Write your slow love song at nighttime and write your quick song during the day. It's that, basically.
Yeah.
And that will be healing to you. Mm. You're starting to get the idea of what the healing is. Yeah.
Yeah, I am.
Yeah. We still have to live. That's the bottom line. And a lot of the things we do in our lives are not good for us, but we can do them in a better way that helps us. So one of the things I always ask people is, what is it they want?
I really want to feel and be and live healthy, have my strength back like I'm doing, having the energy and the drive and the desire. Mm-hmm. I know those sound like fiery words, but those are such important things for me to want to get out of bed every day, mm-hmm. to love this experience, to be so happy and grateful that I have my health in such a place now where I enjoy it. I enjoy doing the things, not that I used to do. I'm enjoying doing more. As I said, I do more things just because it's more exciting, more adventures, more this. Mm. I'm really, that's what I want. I want to make sure that my adventures are fulfilling. The love I'm making is more loving, and the people around me, and everything just has to be more heightened in a sense of which it's a deeper connection.
Yeah.
And I want that. I want that with my music. I want that with my releases. I want that with my fame or recognition, and I want that with the friends and the family and my own children to have a deeper and more meaningful, because things mean more to me. Mm. That's been my want.
So, Michael Beckwith, he's from Agape Church.
Yeah.
And we were at the 36-year anniversary. And something he said struck both Yogini and I was, be with people who want more for you than from you.
Mm. I love you.
Love.
All right, so we just finished up with Taylor. And her theme is really about grounding and being grounded. Because when you have a lot of fire, earth, and air, fire and air, you know, air starts to make the fire larger, makes it hotter. So the body starts to get drier and it disturbs the digestive system. So really it's about everything calming down, so quieter. So one of the things you can do is slow breathing. In and out inhalations should be slow because everything starts to become more grounded. And then food should be more grounded. So salads are not good. Raw vegetables aren't good. Raw food in general isn't good because it's got a lot of air in it. So it's much more about cooked food and grounding food, things with a lot more oil in them. So everything that you think about when you want to calm down the air, especially in your colon, it's going to be things to do with earthiness, right? So that's really the theme with Taylor. And really for Taylor, it's going to be about, can she get that groundedness in? Because her nature is getting her to move, sing, be out there. So what she's got working for her is creativity, passion, love of life. What she's got working against her is trying to find that groundedness. And that's really the story of all of us. You know, can we find that balance? So we're going to see if she really comes up and gets that groundedness in her life.